Second application of dimensional analysis to derive new formula. How to derive new formula or new relation from dimensional analysis? Like this question is given to you, centripetal force F depends upon mass of object M, velocity of object V, radius of circle R. Derive relation or formula from dimensions. In these types of numerical, you are always given one physical quantity like force. It depends upon or may depend upon these three different parameters. In this case, it is mass, velocity, and radius. Then you start with step number one. This force, let us say it is directly proportional to mass raised to the power x, velocity raised to the power y, and radius raised to the power z. These x, y, z are powers, and these are unknown constants which are to be found in this particular numerical. See, we are finding relation between force and mass, velocity, radius. So what will be the final answer? Maybe mass raised to the power 1, mass raised to the power 2. We want to know what will be the relation. So for that, we consider three different numbers, three different powers, x, y, z. And our aim is to find these parameters, x, y, z. Then there will be the relation. This is step number 1. Whatever physical quantity given to you, put it on the left hand side. Dependent parameters, put it like this. Directly proportional to first parameter raised power x, second parameter raised power y, third parameter raised power z. Now, remove this proportionality sign and apply one dimensionless constant. Now, since you want to find correct formula, then from homogeneity principle, left hand side dimension must be equal to right hand side dimension. From homogeneity principle. Now apply the dimensions. Dimension of force MLT minus 2. This K is dimensionless constant. So no dimensions. Mass having dimension M. Velocity having dimension LT minus 1. Radius having dimension L. You must know all the dimensions. Then you are able to solve this particular numerical. Now mass raised power x. So whole dimension raised power x. Similarly velocity raised to the power y. So this LT minus 1 raised power y. And radius raised power z. This dimension of radius L raised power z. Now separate them. M raised power x, L raised power y, T raised power minus y, L raised power z. Now you know bases are same, powers are added up. This L raised to the power y and L raised to the power z can be written as L raised power y plus z. And whatever remaining, copy it, M raised power x, T raised power minus y. Now on the left hand side, it is MLT minus 2. Point number 3, compare powers. Compare powers both sides. Here mass raised power 1, here mass raised power x. On comparing, x is 1. L raised power 1, L raised power y plus z. So y plus z is 1. T raised power minus 2 and T raised power minus y. Now you solve it. So you are having y is equal to 2. Now from this you need to find z. Z is 1 minus y. So 1 minus 2. So z is minus 1. Now in the step number 4, you will put these values of x, y and z in this point with a constant. So copy it. F is equal to k m raised power x, v raised power y, R raised power z. Now x, y, z. X is 1. y is 2 and z is minus 1. So f is k mv square by r. Put it in denominator, so minus sign will become positive. This is centripetal force. This is first numerical based on this. Revise it. You know, all the numericals based on same concept. But question will change, dimensions will change. What to do in these numericals? I repeat. One physical quantity will be given, like centripetal force is given. Put it on left hand side. Three dependent parameters will be given. Put them on right hand side, like mass, velocity, radius, and consider, let us say this force is directly proportional to m raised to the power x, v raised to the power y, r raised to the power z. Then our aim is to find x, y, z. See, on putting x, y, z, we are having proper relation between these three and force. Now remove this proportionality sign, apply dimensionless constant. Now dimensionally it must be equal if you want to have correct answer, correct formula. So put the values of dimension, then compare powers on both the sides, then you are able to put answers in this equation with constant. Breathe in slowly and gradually. Now see, there are so many questions based on this. Now see, this is most important question. Time period of simple pendulum may depend upon number one, mass of the object, number two, length of the thread, number three, g, acceleration due to gravity. Now this is the next question. Derive relation from dimensions or dimensional analysis. Now how will you solve it? You will solve it like this. Left hand side, time period is given which depends upon this. May depend upon this. May means one physical quantity may not be coming in expression. So this t on the left hand side directly to mass raised power x, l raised power y, g raised power z. Apply constant which is dimensionless. Apply dimensions. Time period having dimension t. K has no dimension. Mass has dimension m. Length has dimension l. Acceleration due to gravity having dimensions lt minus 2. Solve it. M raised power x, l raised power y, l raised power z, l raised power minus 2z. Then again same, bases are same, powers are added up. So on the left hand side it is t. There is no mass, no length. So m raised power 0, l raised power 0. Anything raised power 0 is 1. Now compare powers. 0 is equal to x. And 0 is equal to y plus z. Minus 2z is 1. See, t raised power 1, t raised power minus 2z. Z is minus 1 by 2. Now from here y is minus z. Minus of minus 1 by 2. It is plus 1 by 2. So x, y, z. Now you have got x, y, z. Put in the values in this second expression. See, this t is k, m raised power x, l raised power y, g raised power z. Now put in the values. X is 0, y is 1 by 2, and z is minus 1 by 2. This is minus 1 by 2. Breathe in. Anything raised power 0 is 1. That means time period of simple pendulum is not depending upon mass. It is not coming in the expression. L raised power 1 by 2. Put this g in denominator to make this sign positive, this power sign. So this will be g raised power 1 by 2. Write them collectively. L by g whole power 1 by 2. So final answer is k under the root L by g. Similarly, now see the next question. Now he says frequency. Frequency of sonometer depends upon number one, mass per unit length, that is given m. Number two, length of wire, Number 3, it is depending upon T, tension in the wire. Derive the relation dimensionally. Now derive it. How will you derive? Same way, same technique. This frequency is depending upon these three parameters. So frequency directly proportional to m raised to the power x, l raised to the power y, t raised to the power z. This is most important question. Remove this sign and put constant, dimensionless constant sign. Now focus, breathe in slowly and gradually. This is the trap of the numerical. M seems to be mass, but focus, this is the same question as we have done already. This is m, symbol is m, but written mass per unit length. So it is mass upon length. So dimensions will be m upon l, that means ml minus 1. Focus it. यहां आपको लिखना पड़ेगा एम एल माइनस वन सीम्स टू बी मास बट इट इज गिवन मास पर यूनिट लेंथ वट एवर गिवन टू यू फोकस ऑन दैट सो एम एल माइनस वन रेस पावर एक्स दिस इज लेंथ लेंथ मीन्स लेंथ एल रेस पावर वाई नाउ व्हाट अबाउट टी इफ यू आर इन हरी अगेन दिस टी सीम्स टू बी टेम्परेचर सीम्स टू बी टाइम बट दिस टी इज टेंशन इन द वायर विच इज फोर्स अप्लाइड ऑन वायर Force applied on wire means it is force. So dimensions of force MLT, MLT minus 2 you should write in place of T. So it is MLT minus 2. This T is tension. Remember T is tension. So whole power Z. This is frequency. You know frequency is reciprocal to time period. So it is 1 upon T. That means T minus 1. Now you are able to solve it yourself. See, this is mass, m raised power x, m raised power z, so x plus z, l raised power minus x, l raised power plus y, l raised power plus z, and t raised power minus 2z. You know, bases are same, powers are added up. On the LHS, t minus 1. No mass, no length. Compare powers both the sides. Mass raised power x plus z, mass raised power 0, so x plus z 0. Similarly, minus x plus y plus z, power to length, length ki power 0, so it will be 0. T raised power minus 1 and T raised power minus 2z. Now simplify, z is 1 by 2 and x is minus of z, minus of 1 by 2. Now find y. So leave this y, take them on the RHS, minus x becomes plus x minus z. What is x? Minus 1 by 2. What is z? 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, it is minus 1, remember. Now put in the second expression here with the constant. It is n, k, m raised power x, l raised power y, t raised power z. So k, x is minus 1 by 2, length raised power y, it is minus 1, z is 1 by 2. So write it in a proper manner. M in the denominator with the power plus 1 by 2, length in the denominator with power plus 1, t remains in numerator. So write in proper manner, k by l. See this, it is whole power 1 by 2. So you write like this, under the whole under the root T by N. Breathe in slowly and gradually. Now see the next, this one. Frequency depends upon number 1, surface tension, that is S. Number 2, density, rho. Number 3, radius, R. Now derive the relation. How will you solve? Frequency directly to S raised power X, rho raised power Y, R raised power Z. Now surface tension is force upon length. You know how to find dimensions. MLT minus 2 upon length. So it will be MT minus 2. Density, you know, mass upon volume. ML minus 3. Radius means L. You solve it and the final answer will be under the root S by rho R cube. You know, remind this step. It is K. S raised power 1 by 2. Rho raised power minus 1 by 2. And R raised to the power cube root. So it will be in the denominator. R raised to the power 3 by 2. So minus 3 by 2 it will come. Breathe in again. Similarly, this one, again most important, rate of flow of liquid in a pipe depends upon number one, radius of pipe, number two, pressure gradient. Pressure gradient may be given symbol like this, PG, or it may be given P by L, or symbol may be given P only. Don't worry about symbol. Symbol may be this, may be this, may be this, but it is pressure gradient. And third is coefficient of viscosity. Derive the formula from dimensions. So first of all, know the dimensions. Rate of flow is volume flowing per unit time. Then radius, radius length. Pressure gradient is pressure upon length. And pressure is force upon area upon length. So it will be force upon area into length. You know, coefficient of viscosity, eta. It is called force per unit area divided by velocity gradient. But you may remember this formula directly. ML minus 1, T minus 1. Now for deriving this, on the left hand side, it is rate of flow directly to radius raised power x. Maybe this symbol, this or this. Any symbol you may take. P by L whole power y and eta raised power z. When you simplify, answer is R raised power 4 pressure gradient divided by eta. So this constant is unknown for dimensions. You should write with K. Breathe in slowly and gradually. Now again, most important, listen it very, very carefully. If speed of light C H Planck constant and capital G gravitational constant, were taken as fundamental units, then write dimensional formula for mass or of mass, or you may write this question as this: derive mass in terms of speed of light, gravitational constant and Planck constant. Now there are so many questions. In place of speed of light, Planck constant and gravitational constant, he may give any three parameter: force, velocity, pressure. He may give any three parameters. Let us consider them as fundamental units. Now find the relation of mass, yeah, units of mass, dimensions of mass in terms of these three. Don't worry, it is a question of 2D derive. So it is very, very special question. You think this question as mass in terms of CGH you are going to derive. So how will you write? You know, mass is directly proportional to C raised power x. g raised power y, h raised power z. You know, dimensionless constant. Then put in the value of dimensions. M having dimension m, k is dimensionless, speed of light having dimension lt minus 1, gravitational constant having dimension m minus 1, l cube t minus 2, and Planck constant having dimension m l square t minus 1. Put the powers x, y and z. Solve it. Masses, c masses, mass raised power minus y, mass raised power z. So minus y plus z. Length raised to the power x, length raised to the power 3y, length raised to the power 2z. So when bases are same, powers are added up. Now think of time. It is t minus 1, t minus 2, t minus 1 with the powers. So t minus x minus 2y minus z. On the left hand side only mass is given. No length, no time. So length raised power 0, time raised power 0. Compare these three. Minus y plus z is equal to 1 because mass ki power, mass ki power. Compare the power of mass. Similarly, power of length. X plus 3y plus 2z is equal to 0. And power of time, here 0, here it is minus x minus 2y minus z is equal to 0. Let us say it is first, it is second, and it is third equation. You know how to solve these equations. See this. First equation is given in terms of y and z. So cancel x in second and third by adding. So from second and third, x plus 3y plus 2z is equal to 0 minus x minus 2y minus z is equal to 0. On addition, ye cancel, 3y minus 2y, y plus z is equal to 0. This is equation number 4. Now from first, minus y plus z is 1. Again on adding, when you add them, y will be cancelled, z, z, 2z is 1. So z is 1 by 2. Now from 4th, from 4th y plus z is 0. So y will be minus z, that means minus 1 by 2. Similarly, from either of second or third, let us say from second, x plus 3y plus 2z is equal to 0. We have z, we have y, now we are finding x. So x will be minus 3y minus 2z. So y is minus 1 by 2 and z is 1 by 2. So x will be 3 by 2 minus 1. It is 1 by 2. So final answer is mass is equal to c raised power x, and it was gravitational constant raised power y and Planck constant raised power z. So put the value of c raised power 1 by 2 x, and y is also, y is minus 1 by 2 and z is 1 by 2. So this is your final answer. You may write it with constant as well as you may write it in a proper way, C H upon G under the root. Got it?